बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम टू ऑल ऑफ यू। वेलकम क्लास 9P। माय नेम इज़ सबीन ज़ारा, आई एम योर बायोलॉजी टीचर। अकॉर्डिंग टू योर लेसन प्लान, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट अवर चैप्टर नंबर 7, दैट इज़ बायो एनर्जेटिक्स। आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू द टॉपिक ATP, एडीनोसिन ट्राइफॉस्फेट, द सेल्स एनर्जी करेंसी। My goal for today is to help you understand what the ATP is. Today I will be covering these three main points that are under the heading of ATP: discovery, role, and the components of ATP. Okay, let's talk about discovery of the ATP. As we know that ATP is the universal energy carrier in the living cells. The German chemist Karl Lohmann discovered ATP in 1929. Let's look particularly at the role of ATP. As we know that ATP is the main source of energy for most cellular processes. ATP finds use in several cellular processes. ATP plays a critical role in the transport of macromolecules such as proteins and lipids into and out of the cell. ATP has key functions both in intracellular and extracellular signaling. ATP is critical for the contraction of muscles. To draw the lecture to a close, I am going to discuss the components of ATP. There are three main components of ATP. The number one, adenine; number two, ribosomes; number three, phosphate group. Adenine basically is a double ring nitrogenous base, and ribose is a 5-carbon sugar. And phosphate, if we talk about the phosphate group, it is basically comprises of a linear chain of 3 phosphates. Some of your students might just be interested to know that the difference of ATP, ADP, AMP. In ATP, there are 3 phosphates, while in ADP, there are 2 phosphates, and AMP only 1 phosphate. As we know that ATP, T means tri, if there is D, di means 2, and if there is M means mono means just 1. Feel free to ask any question. Stay blessed. Allah Hafiz.